Hello dog lovers, how you doing? Welcome to my video. Tal Minni, tal. Today's video is about how to stop your dog or your puppy from biting and nipping. Well, it took me about a couple of days to make Prince over here understand that he shouldn't be biting or nipping me, and he understood it quite quickly. Now, one important thing to understand here is that it is normal for a puppy to bite, because that is how he explores. For him, his world, his exploration of the world around him, the environment around him, is through biting, is through his mouth. So he is going to bite, and this is going to teach him what he can and what he cannot bite and nip, and how much pressure to add per bite, you know. So these are the things that he learns. If a puppy is not biting and nipping, then there is an issue. Then you should be worried. You need to take him to a vet or a dog psychologist or something, because it is normal. So this is the first thing that we have to understand. Now, when a puppy comes over and he's biting you, he's basically trying to understand what he can bite, like I said. Now, the way you stop a puppy biting is, first of all, you should not get down to the level of the puppy and cuddle him like this and then treat him like like as if he's a human baby, because he is not. First is, you need to assert your dominance, and you need to teach the puppy his pecking order. You know, you need to show, you know, establish a, as they say, a hierarchy. This is very important. And the way you do that is, you don't go down and cuddle him. I mean, if you've seen an alpha dog, he's always standing up straight, and his subordinates and the other dogs, which are lower in the pecking order, come up to him and greet him, and you know, but he does not go around sniffing around and cuddling and playing around with them. So no. Second thing, till the puppy learns not to bite, you should not be playing with him, like getting down his level and playing as in, you know, playing with your fingers, your hands, and turning him around and doing things like that, because then he thinks that you know, you are at the same level of hierarchy as he is, and then, you know, he will then try to dominate you. And this is with even a dog, not just a puppy. So whenever you first meet a puppy, you stand over him, and no matter how much he is playing around with you, you don't even look at him. You look away, and maybe you can put your hands behind your back, stand, you know, keep doing this for every 5 minutes, and then walk. When a puppy comes over and he tries to nip you, you just make a sound. You never say no. You say mm, and he should understand that that is not allowed. And then start walking away. Let the puppy follow you, like how Prince is following me now. Now, this is very important. Don't say no to everything. You make a sound like mm, that way, so that he understands that that sound is associated with something that you dislike and you don't want him to do. Now, this is very important. Now, if you were to keep saying no to everything, the puppy would think that is his name. No, you know. So you don't want to reserve that. I mean, you want to reserve that word for something very severe, you know. So this is very important to do. Third thing, if a puppy is trying to, you know, despite you doing all that, and he's sometimes puppies get very excited, and in their excitement they will ignore certain sounds you make, you know, even if they've learned it. When that happens, then you need to make a very sharp hissing sound, and then make a V like that, and push it between his neck like that, you know, like that. Now, this will This sort of simulates what a mama dog would do when a puppy gets unruly, you know? So when a puppy gets very unruly, a mama dog would straight away hold him with his mouth, you know, his neck, that way, and pin him down. So this sort of teaches a puppy that, okay, this is not right. So first thing is establishing a hierarchy. The moment you get a puppy, you do not cuddle him or anything. I mean, you can pat him. It does not mean that you don't touch him at all. You pat him, but then your pat should mean something to him. It should be a very important event for him when you pat. He should understand that he's done something really great, that you're patting him. If you keep patting him all the time, he will lose the importance of your patting, you know. But don't just keep patting him and cuddling him, right? First thing is establishing hierarchy. You have to show him what his pecking order is and which is lower in rank than yours. You are his boss. You are the alpha dog, right? So that's one thing. Second thing, see that? Second thing, of course, is, and not getting down to your knees and, you know, treating him like a human baby. He is not a human baby. When you get a puppy, try to understand, this puppy is going to grow up very, very, very quickly, you know, in a matter of months. And then you are going to have an unmanageable dog on your hands, not a pup anymore. Just so, ignore all those cute looks, because they don't last for too long. What you're going to have for a much, much, much longer time is a fully grown up dog. So you need to understand this. You need to treat this objectively, you know. So that's the first thing. And the second thing is not to say no to everything, you know. So whenever he comes and he tries to nip, you make a sound which she should associate with something that you dislike. You say and then you walk away. You make that sound and then you walk away. So puppy knows you don't like it, right? And you have to repeat this. And the third thing, if he's going to, you know, sometimes when puppy gets really excited and ignores those sounds, then you make a sharp hissing sound, make a V, and at the back of his head, you know, sorry, back of his head or neck, hold it, pin him down. Like, every time he does it, and then release him, you know? So, like I said, this simulates what a mama dog would do when her pup would get unruly. And this disciplines the pup. This makes the pup understand what he has to do, what he shouldn't be doing. And trust me, in a couple of days, the puppy pretty much understands that, you know, he has to behave himself. And he does. So my pup stopped nipping and biting me in just a couple of days after he came. He understood it's not allowed. Now, don't get me wrong. It doesn't mean he doesn't get excited or anything. He does get excited, and sometimes he still wants to come, and he'll open his mouth, and he, you know, he'll hold my jeans or something, you know, my pants and my footwear. When he does that, all I have to do is say and he right away releases it. He understands. So this is very important. Once you've established that hierarchy and everything, and then you can, you know, you can cuddle him. But even then, don't go down to his level and kiss him and cuddle him and you know, don't let him lick you and everything. It may look very, very pretty, but it's not. Especially when you're going to have a large dog on your hands, you know, very soon. You don't do that. You want to control the dog, and this is what is best for the dog. Trust me. When you are going to have a dog which is unmanageable, what are you going to do? You're going to give him away to a shelter. If they don't find another home, they're going to euthanize him. Is that what you want for your dog? Or you want a dog that is well disciplined, well behaved, with whom you like to be around, and with whom you're confident taking him out, introducing him to your friends and relatives, that he's controllable, and where the dog knows when to get aggressive, when not to get aggressive, when to guard, when not to guard. See, this is what you're looking for in a guard dog. Not, you know, not giving, not lavishing him with all that human love and everything, which is just going to spoil him. He won't understand all those things. You're just going to, you're, by doing that, you tell him that, you know what, I am your subordinate, you are my master, you are my alpha dog, I'm going to listen to you. And when he grows up and you don't listen to him, guess what? You got trouble. Right? So, I hope this helped. Thanks a lot for watching. And thanks a lot for tuning in. And until next time, ciao.